Dear students, welcome to the business studies class, part 16, standardization and simplification. Standardization refers to the process of setting standard for every activity in business. Standards may be sets for raw material, time, product, machinery, method, working condition, etc. These standards are the benchmarks which must be adhered to during the production. The objectives of standardizations are, first one, to conform a given line or product to fixed types, size and characteristics. Second one, to establish interchangeability of manufactured parts and products. Third one, to establish standards of excellence and quality in materials. Fourth one, to establish standards of performance of men and machines. Next, simplification. Simplification means putting an end to the unnecessary types, qualities, size, weight, etc. For example, it is all right for a shoe manufacturing company to manufacture shoes of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sizes. But if it is stopped manufacturing shoe of 0.5, 1, 1.25, 1.5, 2.25, 2.5, it will lead to wastage. The main objectives of simplifications are, first one, to eliminate unnecessary diversity of product. Second one, to save cost of labor, machine and tools. Second, time study. It refers to a technique of determining the standard time required to complete a well-defined job. The standard time is determined on the basis of average time taken by the several experience of the same work. The main objectives of the study are, first one, to get the estimated figure of labor cost. Second one, to determine the number of required workers. Third one, to decide about the suitable incentive plan. Third one, motion study. It refers to the technique used to study the movement of men, material and machines with a view to eliminate unnecessary motions. The movie camera used to conduct this study. The main objectives of this study is to eliminate the unnecessary motions. For example, during an experiment, it was found that while laying a bricks, a mason was conducting 18 different movements. But after eliminating the unnecessary movements, the number of movements would be reduced to 5. Next one, Factico study. It refers to the technique of determining the duration and the frequency of rest intervals to complete a particular job. The rest refreshes the workers. They work again with their full capacity. The main objectives of this study is to maintain the efficiency level of workers. For example, normally in a plant, work takes place in 3 shifts of 8 hours each. Even in a single shift, a worker has to be given some rest interval to take her or his tea or lunch, etc. Next one, method study. It refers to the technique of identifying one best way to do a particular job. The main objectives of this study is to minimize the cost of production and maximize the quality and the level of customer satisfaction. For example, while assembling a car, the sequence of operation Place for men, mission and raw material should be decided in advance. Last one, differential piece wage system. Taylor has advocated the adoption of differential wage system in order to motivate the employees. According to this system, wages are paid on the basis of work done and not on the basis of time spent in doing the work. For example, let the standard output per day be 20 units and the two wages rate to be rupees 5 per unit and rupees 4 per unit respectively. Worker A produces 20 units in a day, and in doing so he earned rupees 100, means 20 units into rupees 5 per unit. Another worker B produces only 18 units in a day, and hence he will earn only 72, means 18 units into 4 per unit. In this way, even though B has produced only 2 units less than A, the difference in their wages will be 100 minus 72, means 28. This part is completed. Thank you.